Welcome back. In the late 90s, a group of teens from rival neighborhoods on Chicago's West Side formed an unlikely bond. They became the first all-black high school rowing team, and the word crew took on a whole new meaning for them. A documentary about this band of brothers is set to hit the big screen later this month. Take a look at this clip from A Most Beautiful Thing.
Some people ask what college you're gonna go to when you grow up. In our neighborhood, the big question was what gang you're gonna join.
A kid got shot in front of Manly, killed him dead right on the curb. It kind of makes you lose hope for your community.
How do you break out of that? But a chance encounter changed everything.
I walked inside the lunchroom and I see this boat.
I didn't even know what rowing was.
We don't even swim.
You gonna take some West Side kids over to the lake?
Nah, that's not gonna work.
It brought guys from different neighborhoods, from rival gangs, together in one boat.
When it's calm and you're out there, it takes your mind away from any problems that you have.
It brightened my life.
There was something about the water that gave us peace, and we all needed that.
Now, 20 years later, they're back on the water.
What are we training for here?
Chicago Sprints.
We're trying to rewrite history here.
Training star today, Arshay.
Malcolm's doing this to show his son another way. Preston's going back in time to undo his mistakes. Alvin's racing to celebrate the fact he's still alive, that he's still here.
Now you get an opportunity to inspire another generation.
The film is based on the memoir by rower and now motivational speaker Arshay Cooper. I recently spoke with Arshay and Mary Mazzio, the director of the documentary, and retired basketball star Grant Hill, one of the executive producers. Arshay and Mary and Grant, thank you for talking with me. Arshay, let's start with you, because this documentary really is your story, kind of based on your book. And while the documentary is about rowing, it really, in a lot of ways, is about trauma too, isn't it, Arshay?
Yeah, a lot of trauma. Just, you know, when you're surrounded with so much violence, or surviving, or really just trying to feed yourself and your family's trying to feed themselves, you go to school just with a sense of toughness and not really being yourself and just trying to figure out how to protect yourself every day. And the film touches a lot on that kind of trauma that started with our grandparents who lived in the South, who deal with a lot of racism. And then my mom, who was living in a time with war on drugs, and how the trauma was passed down to my generation. And so the water was there to help me get over that.
Mary, you were an Olympic rower. The sport is very, 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 very white.
Very, very.
I probably left out some berries. Do you think that's going to change? And could it change?
I think, honestly, we're seeing in front of us people that are seeking to use the film as a starting point about a dialogue around privilege. And when you think of privilege, our sport is rampant with privilege, right? And so that metaphor for getting in the same boat, you can't move forward without being together. And that's true in the sport, and it's also so true in the troubled times that we're seeing ourselves now.
Grant, do you think there is a role for sports in this complicated, messy conversation about race that we're kind of in the middle of right now? And what is that role?
Well, yeah, I think there's a valuable role in sports. Look, sports, I think, can be a healer, can be a unifier. I think it can be an example of people from all walks of life coming together and showing that they can work together and have a common goal and a common theme. And there's a moment in the film where Arshay invites the police department, Chicago Police Department, to train and to actually get in the boat with the team. And that was a beautiful, important, powerful moment in the film that I think really will resonate now in the world that we're in.
Arshay, why have the Chicago Police Department in on this 20 years later after you'd all gotten out of school and now you were coming back to do this race? Why did you think that they needed to be part of this?
To move forward, right? To truly move forward, what I learned from rowing is to get together and have a conversation. And they don't know our names, right? They work in this community from 8 to 5 every day for years, and there's no relationship. But sports unite people, just like Grant said. So if I can invite them out just for a row, the conversation will start, and they will have to learn from us, meaning their ears will be open. And that was an opportunity to get to know who we are and how we contribute to our community and how much we care. And that was the goal. You know, when this event happened with George Floyd, they text me, right? I was able to tell them that this is not right. And I'm so glad I was able to do that. And that was the goal. That was the plan, to start these conversations, not among each other, but the ones, right, that is a part of the police department. And so and that was important. And that's why I invited them out.
Arshay Cooper and Mary Mazzio and Grant Hill. Thanks, guys. I appreciate you talking about the project. You can watch the full interview about the documentary on matteroffact.tv. Depending on the status of COVID-19, AMC theaters have scheduled a limited release of A Most Beautiful Thing on July 31st.